biggest South Asian media group, Y Media.
Y Media.
Y Media has newspaper, midweek, radio, South Asian Pulse, television.
You are watching Channel Y.
Channel Y.
A South Asian Canadian channel. Online, SouthAsianDaily.com. The biggest South Asian media group, Y Media.
You are watching Channel Y.
Channel Y.
A South Asian Canadian channel.
Welcome to Channel Y. I'm your host, Yudhvir Jaiswal. Peel Police, which is the Canada's third largest police force and the second largest in Ontario after the Toronto Police. The largest, of course, is Toronto Police. Then we have the Montreal Police, and this is Canada's third largest Peel Police. And we have none other than the Chief of Peel Police, Jennifer Evans. Chief, welcome to South Asian Today. How are you?
Thank you very much. I'm excellent. Thank you very much for having me here tonight.
You're very welcome. Thank you especially for taking out time from such a busy schedule. It's the first time you're here at the Channel Y Studios. On behalf of Y Media Group, I welcome you here at the Channel Y Studios.
Thank you.
Chief, first of all, let's talk about this. There has been a lot of discussion regarding street checks recently.
Yes.
And I know now the province has acted upon that. So what are your comments on that?
Well, actually, I can tell you that on Friday, we went to our Police Services Board and we announced to the Police Services Board that as of April 20th, so last Wednesday, Peel Regional Police are fully compliant with the new legislation. So we were doing street checks before. So now the regulation talks about the collection of identifying information. So now we are now compliant with the spirit and the language of the, and we made a media release just today announcing that today.
Okay, and do you think that this will still be helpful? I know there was a little bit of a concern initially that yes, the frontline officers, they certainly need the tools, and we all need a safer environment. So
yes.
Do you think this legislation is well balanced?
Well, I think it was a difficult task that the province had, mm-hmm. and I think that they recognize that we need to balance the rights of the people in the community, as well as to still allow for the police to have tools to inquire into suspicious activity. So I think we're going to see in time what the results of the new regulation. So to say, we have changed our processes to comply with that. And I'm encouraging my officers to still get out and investigate suspicious behavior, because I think the community need that. There's lots going on in the community.
That's right. And now let's quickly move on one question which I get almost regularly on my radio talk shows. That's that, whenever an officer is suspended, they're suspended with pay.
Yes.
So what is your opinion on that?
So the province, the police are right now governed under the Police Service Act of Ontario. And for the last few years, the chiefs, including myself, across the province, have been trying to advocate to the ministry, to say we would like to be able to suspend our officers without pay. There are certain circumstances that officers, commit infractions, they do things that are wrong, that we may suspend them with pay, and we will charge them under the Police Act, and we will discipline them for other actions. But there are certain circumstances that are so serious that we as chiefs, I would like to be able to suspend my officer without pay. So that's what we've been advocating with the province to try, and if they're doing changes to the Police Services Act, we would like them to change that. So it gives the chiefs the ability to suspend without pay. And I think it brings about the community trust, the public trust. It's important that, I am the disciplinarian for my police service. So officers commit something, an infraction, then I should be able to. It's under certain circumstances, if I feel that I'm going to terminate them because of their actions, then I would be able to suspend them without pay. It's very serious. A lot of activities going on with the government.
Right. And one of the things that usually we talk, crime in the region of Peel. What is your opinion?
Well, I'm happy to say that while crime is occurring, Peel Regional Police are very vigilant in apprehending offenders. We have our crime rate is lower than a lot of major cities across Canada, and yet our solvency rate is higher. So last year we had 16 homicides, which is a tragic event, 16 lives that were lost in the region of Peel. But I'm happy to report that all 16 were solved. So that was 100% solvency rate of our homicides, which is our most serious offense. So I know our officers out there work very hard to try and solve the crimes.
We've got to take a very short break, and we'll come back after this very short break.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Once again, we'd like to remind our viewers that we are talking to the Peel Police Chief, Jennifer Evans, and we will be discussing a few more issues right after this short break. Keep watching Channel Y.
Channel Y, a South Asian Canadian channel. Call Rogers or Bell today and subscribe to Channel Y.
Channel Y.
For more information, visit SouthAsiaDaily.com.
are watching Channel Y.
Channel Y.
A South Asian Canadian channel.